Hello, everyone. I am Grandmaster Maurice Ashley, and I'm a commentator for chess. But, you know, back in the day, I was indeed a player. People don't remember that so much because I've done commentary for so long. But I used to play chess, certainly had my successes in events. And for me, chess has always been this wild passion, attacking aggressive games. And the game I'm going to show you today is indeed one of those. And it's actually this position that I'm so proud of. It came from a game played in 1993 in St. Martin, beautiful island actually, the beautiful island of St. Martin, where there was this great tournament. And at the time I was a young IM trying to get to the Grandmaster title. And I played against a famous American player, actually originally from Latvia, but came to the United States, Alexander Shabalov, and indeed forged an incredible Hall of Fame career here in the States, winning the US championships multiple times and tearing up the tournament circuit as well. I faced off against him with the black pieces here, and he was super aggressive in the game. As you can see, white has quite a bit of space with the pawn on e5 and developed pieces looking great. But his last move, bishop to c6, was not exactly well called for in this position. I'm playing a hedgehog setup, and it's somewhat passive looking, but the hedgehog is famous for having its quills, and you have to be careful. And bishop c6 was not careful, and I was able in this position to uncork a move that I really love. That is the move knight takes g3. Boom, a big time hit in this position. Taking on g3 really exposes the white king, and it seems like the white king shouldn't be in that much trouble, because after all of black's pieces are sitting on the first and second rank. But it's high danger to white. In this position, if white decides to play king takes on g3, black will continue the aggressive play with knight takes on e5. The point being that although this knight is hanging, bishop d6 lines up that pin against the queen and the king. And also, this rook is not really hanging, because there's all kinds of discoveries that could happen in this position. There's knight to d3 check. Look at that nasty attack there. This one as well. And the king is just caught in the crosshairs of the black pieces. King to h4, virtually the only move. Queen h4 check. And then suddenly bishop to e7 is mate. So in the position after knight takes g3, Shabalov decided to wait one move and play queen to f2. Thinking that because of all his threats, he's pinning my knight here to my rook. I still can't take because of a fork with knight takes c6. This would give him a chance. But I continued in sacrificial style with knight takes on e5. Just a great move. Again, if queen takes, bishop to d6, and it's pin him and win him all day in this position. There's no way to get out of this. In addition, I'm threatening knight takes on c6, which just makes it extremely powerful, a devastating attack. So after knight takes on e5, he played rook takes e5, queen takes, and now queen takes g3. And he had a trick in mind. Queen takes d4, rook to d1, attacking my queen, preparing to take this rook. Looks almost good for white, but in fact, I had calculated the move bishop to d6, leaving my queen hanging. The point being that if you take here, then just simply bishop takes g3, king takes, and bishop takes, and black is up gobs of material. Bishop to d6, a great move again that continued. So after queen takes d6, queen to f2 check, king to h1, and now queen takes b2, and the final point, the rook is not hanging on the e8 square because of the nasty pin. Black ends up two pawns in exchange. White tried to fight with knight to e4, and after a couple of moves, very aggressive on my part, f5, stopping the move knight to f6. White had to retreat after queen to e2, rook g1, and queen to e3. This is the devastating position I meant. White with the knight on d6, advancing, thinking it was threatening anything, did not do anything whatsoever, as now the move king to h2, rook e d8, and he desperately sacrificed. But notice that after rook takes, there is no perpetual check, and so here he resigned. I really appreciated this move, knight takes on g3 with check. It's one of my favorite memories in chess. in this position to sacrifice, to continue with more and more sacrifices. When people say, what's my best game? I may have played better games, but I don't think I played a better combination. This one, I was really proud of.